So how is everyone's summer? Yeah, I'll go one.
Yeah, you go one, I'll go one.
All right.
We can link up.
Yeah. I'm surprised you're here, Mills.
Me?
Yeah.
Oh, I only missed yesterday because it was my birthday.
Fair. We're student athletes.
Come on.
Student comes first. We need to get our ones and twos right.
Oh, my God.
Catch the damn ball. I'm offside. Mate, if you're flat, you're in. Oh, that's rough. I just can't get enough of the rugger.
Yeah, so last year's Derby Day was a bit of classic sport heartbreak, to be honest. A top performance from the boys throughout the game, and then robbed sort of in the last minute of the match to lose to Essex. So yes, it was a bad day for those involved, but as sport goes, sort of got to take it on the chin, really. Yeah, I think for the boys it was a huge loss, that especially competing so well throughout the entire game and really thinking that it was theirs, sort of coming right at the end of the whistle, that to have it robbed from them, I can imagine is still hurting. There'll be a few players that will want to right some wrongs come this Derby Day, I think. Yeah, pre-season, it was a great time. No work, only playing rugby with your mates. It's a really, really good time of year. Sun's been shining so far, so yeah, it was really good fun. It was nice to get back in and get back into the buzz of rugby straight away from first year, when you just sort of come in and you're a bit nervous. Then coming into pre-season 2 weeks before, you're really getting to cement your friends and getting back to playing some lovely rugby.
Should be cruising through this one by now, come on.
I'm not cruising at all.
Go lads. Fancy playing a bit of rugby this year?
Yeah?
No?
Yeah.
Sure.
Oh, nice, mate. Oh, dear. Slim pickings.
Wow.
Slim pickings on the man front. Not a lot of players.
Fancy a bit of rugby, mate? No, not tempted.
Sure. Is it all right to be like a kind of casual comer to the club? Like,
absolutely.
You come to socials and come like once a week.
So he's our social sex. So you
flick it. Just stick your name down here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Cool. Where'd you play? What position? What? Oh, excellent. Always in media front row.
Yeah.
Key position. So you've got three teams to fill and the Saturday side. Yeah. So.
Like 4 games a week, 23-25 players on the
squad.
Wait, let me
finish this guy. Go on, mate. Fancy playing rugby this year? Yeah?
Give it a go.
Look, there's loads of tasting sessions. You just come down, give it a try. It's like free, you know, it's 4 weeks. Do you go and sign up? Just put your name down so you get the email. Go on, good lad. What's your name, by the way? I'm James. Tom. Where are you from, Tom? Anyway? Oh, yeah, I've been to Sheffield a few times, watched the snooker. What, the Crucible? You live next to the Crucible?
Yeah.
Oh, well, Doncaster is. I was going to say, that's fucking sick. Right, watch out, lads. I have a young Tom from Sheffield in Doncaster. Right. Put your name, UEA, and UEA email, and whatever you do.
Season could be cut short.
Can we tempt you in any rugby, mate?
Huh?
Can we tempt you with any rugby?
When do you guys train?
Mondays and Fridays, 7 till 9.
7 till 9, yeah, okay.
And then we've got two games a week, so an opportunity for everyone to play Wednesday afternoons and Saturday days.
Okay, yeah.
If you'd be keen for it.
Yeah, no, I've played like years ago when I was like 17.
Basically, you're on a Facebook, it's just going, well, have you got your phone now? Do it now if you want. Just because then we can get the bloke to accept you on. Go on UEA Rugby Freshers. Oh man, what happened there? You well, dropped it?
Yeah, I know, it's fucked. I don't know what to talk about. It's like, yeah.
What, on a night out or something?
I don't know.
Was it?
I just woke up one day and it was like,
what? Right.
Well, what was the time, yeah.
So are you a postgrad or a PhD?
No, paramedic science.
Oh, right, I'm pharmacy.
Oh, cool, man.
So, healthcare Sweet. Professionals.
Yeah, so it's like, that's why.
And then Saturday, hopefully we'll have a fixture, so have a game in the local leagues. But just, mate, just come down, have a see what you feel. Plenty of people there. There'll be like 100 kids, so it's all good. But, mate, get right down here. Ta-da.
Season, yeah, all right. When the calendar came out for who we're playing, I'm straight away. I'm looking at Cop Ones away, and that's a circle fixture. Dig deep. You don't stop until the job is done and the final whistle.
We deserve to win this league, and we'll show them what we've got, boys. Are you ready, boys?
Show them, boys. We are the
Thank you.
Fair enough.
Not every day all these silly offloads are going to pull off like they did today. We need to try and take it in, compose it a bit more, but today it worked, we played fucking great today. So
boys, the first 10 minutes set the tone for the rest of our fucking season. And boy has it. Alright, we fucking took it to them so hard today. And we just kept fucking pounding it. They didn't expect it, boys. And we were fucking relentless. And it paid off, boys. It's class result.
Boys, think about the message.
Boys, there's nothing more to say than let's have a fucking great night, boys. That was great.
And then they went, yeah, you can go, he's always so sorry. And he's got
this guy was literally telling the chair and a like white rabbit with a blizzard.
Mills starts off. Hi everybody, I'm Mills and I played one today.
Hi Mills!
One thing I did good today, I strummed everyone off the park.
Yeah! Yeah.
Hurry up, let's go quick.
Let's go, next Ginger.
Hello, my name's Big Ginger and I played five today.
Hello, Big Ginger!
Yeah, that's what I like. One thing I did bad today is...
Well, good.
I thought I made a few good runs, especially when that geezer tries to sit me down.
It's boom, boom, boom by the bank.
Don't fuck this up.
If you're alone and you need a friend, someone to help you forget your problems, just come along, baby, take my hand. I'll be your lover tonight.
Okay.
Oh, oh, this is what I wanna do. Oh, oh, let's have some fun. Oh, oh, one on one, just me and you. Oh, oh.
Boom, 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 boom. I want you in my room. Let's get the night together. Turn out the forever. Boom, 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 boom. I want to come on room. Let's get the night together. Together in my room.
I always played rugby, I suppose, growing up. Started when I was about 10, 11, and then played all the way through school. And I was thinking about playing other sports, you know, giving them a go, and then sort of went round the sports fair and literally just got grabbed by about four rugby people. And then I sort of just signed up, and then, yeah, haven't looked back. I was always probably going to sign up anyway, but it just stopped me going for pretty much any other sport. I went straight to rugby, signed up and left, and then been here 4 years now, so...
I'm so confused. Bush! Borussia! I gotta be honest, I don't have a fucking Scooby what we're doing. Me v you two now.
Had a beer.
Me v you two.
Had a beer or two.
You ain't lasting more than 30 seconds. I feel like I'm fucking entering new habitats here. What is going on? I should be in the NFL, mate. What is going on, man? Boring! No one likes that. No one likes to see that. So what do? Do I just run? Oh, I don't think I've ever been so confused. I do love drills like this. Had to run a boy down in my air for piss because now I've got a crease in the middle. Right, can we just go home? I feel like this might be the first time I've ever been interviewed.
Yeah, there's nothing much remarkable about you to interview, really.
I can't work out where my face is straight. Like this? My face is straight like this, Fraser. So I feel like I usually sit there with a tilt on my head.
Where's my lunch? Yeah, there you go. Well, I joined rugby because, I don't know, well, you go first. Well, you didn't join rugby.
Yeah, no. So
you were too scared.
I think the right word is hesitant. I only joined in my second year of university. More hesitant, I dabbled a bit in touch rugby and a bit in medics rugby before I made the big leap into UEA RFC. And I think for the same reason why I've done rugby all the time is the reason why I wanted to join, for the camaraderie, for the competition and the fun of rugby, I guess.
I joined rugby because, I don't know, I always thought that it's good to join a sport because like for the social aspects and that. And then I'm absolutely woeful at every other sport, so I was like, if I play a bit of rugby, then I might actually get some game time, because if I'm playing football, there's no way I'm getting any of the other teams. And I played rugby before coming to uni, so it just made sense. But just the Wednesdays in general, like you get a break from doing all your work and that, and then it's just like in the middle of the week, so obviously it makes sense where you can just not do anything for the day, where in third year it probably isn't the best thing to be doing, like just not doing work when you're supposed to be, but it gives you a break from like everyday uni life.
I just love it so much. I mean, that's why like I'll play any opportunity I get. That adrenaline is unparalleled, really. A lot of my friends do come from the rugby club, and I'm thankful for that. I'm grateful for that too. So I wouldn't change it, except for him. But yeah,
you get to know people while you're playing rugby, but you don't like know them, if you know what I'm saying. Like you get to know them like on the pitch and like how they are like at training, like and just like the banter that you give there, but until you go out with them and that, like, it's just a different kind of vibe. Like when you go out, you're not always thinking, oh, I've got to do this in rugby, I've got to do that in rugby. It's more actually getting to know the person and that. And I think without the social side, like a club really isn't like at its tightest. And it helps you in a game as well, because then you get to know the person more and that. So I'd say the social side is huge of it.
I am not looking forward to getting a job, at all. And just when I'm going to be sat there in my little office job or something, looking out the window on a Wednesday, like, oh, I could be playing rugby right now, and look where I am instead.
We cannot give them an inch. We cannot let them breathe. Number four, we've got to be in their faces and don't give them any options. Is that clear? They are very, very beatable. We're at home, this is our ground. Okay, but we are gonna have to really turn it on today. And I mean, when I say turn it on, every single man.
All right, they're a decent outfit. And they're definitely gonna want it for a cup game, all right? Really think about what you've got to do today.
Hey boys, let me tell you something, yeah? These are the fucking best fucking years of our lives, yeah? University, we only get 3 years here. We only get 3 years of these games, and then it's gone. When you're older, you will look back on these. You will look back on these for happy memories. As you look back on this club for your memories, on the pitch and off the pitch, okay? Today, we make a fucking good memory. We don't look back on this and think that was shit and I didn't enjoy it, yeah? What keeps this club together, what keeps us together, is the friendship that we have and the commitment we put into each other on that pitch. Yeah? Look into our eyes now, boys, and look into each other. Because every single person on this team is going to play for each other. You're going to play for that man on the left. You're going to play for that man on the right. Yeah? Call for every fucking inch. When they come in and get nothing, they get nothing. Yeah? We're going to fucking back it up, Jack.
Thank you.
I joined rugby a little bit late. Came to uni thinking, well, I probably weren't going to do rugby. But then went to the first few trial games and stuff, and then went to the first few socials and kind of thought, oh, these are my group of people, these are my group of lads. Just similar sort of thoughts, similar ways of thinking, and it's just top fun. It's good. Just found my group of people in rugby. Yeah? That's why I joined rugby. Being captain's been a really good experience. Learned quite a lot. Very interesting. Learned quite a lot about yourself and what it actually means to be a leader, be a captain. Found out a lot of things. So very interesting experience.
The Wongs got off to an absolute flyer away at Coventry, turning over expected title contenders on their own patch. But to save you a long tale of how many tries we scored, I'll recall what turned out to be one of the more awkward spectating experiences for myself. So it's a roasting hot day in the West Midlands, and I'm filming the game, as per, behind the try line. When I spot this old chap, who's been patrolling the touchline, making his way over to me. He begins to ask a few questions about my camera and my tweed, but the conversation soon runs out of steam when he realised that I have little to no idea about the technicalities of photography or the manufacture of my tweed. So he asks instead what I thought of the game. Our boys need to play a bit safer, I said. Too many silly offloads going awry, especially from our flight half cam. This old chap, he nods thoughtfully. He continues to watch the game. Yeah, to be fair, I continued, he's not in his best game today. Really putting us under the cosh at times with his passing. Do you think so? The guy replies, again. At this point, I feel like the conversation is really getting onto something we can both contribute to. Yeah, his kicking's been shit again. That's how he cost us the game at Loughborough last year. At this moment, the conversation seemed to die extremely quickly, and I felt the bloke's attention drifting elsewhere. After a minute or two silence, I thought I'd better ask. Did he come here to watch Coventry Boys a lot then? No, he said. I'm Cam's dad. In fairness, Cam hasn't been too dreadful this year. In fact, I'd say the whole first team is performing pretty well. Even Wilco's playing out of his skin. Clearly those extra fitness sessions in his house have paid off.
Do you know what? This is the first time I've been in here.
This is the first time.
And I lived in Cotswold Terrace. I lived there for a year.
How long have you two been friends?
Probably since like the first training session.
Yeah, probably wasn't it.
I think we got chatting, found out we were both from the southeast, lived pretty close together, and just got bombed.
Yeah, went well. We played a fair few games with each other in the first year. Kind of bonded that way, like being the fresh, playing in a team that consists of 4 years at university, so there's quite a big age difference in some of them there. So being the same age from the similar region, it just gave us kind of a starting point, didn't it, to really have a chat, and then we've been friends
ever since. I think first
really.
Year tour as well, we got a lot closer, like spending like a full week together, we're in like rooms next to each other as well, just like bonding the whole time.
Well, for me, rugby creates such strong friendships because of the amount of time that we spend together. So Monday night training, Wednesday, the whole day in the game. So especially if you've got away days when you sometimes have meets at 8:30 in the morning, you're not getting back to 6 o'clock in the evening, and then Friday night training, and then Saturday, games down at Colney or just away in the Saturday side local fixture of the league. Huge for us. Like, it's 4 days out of a 7 day week that we spend together. Spend a lot of time at lunch together, spend time in the library together, so I think rugby is really important like that.
it's also a very, like, because it's a contact sport, it's very close. You put your body on the line for your mates, and in most sports you don't really do that, so you get quite a strong bond with them that in other sports like football, of course, you wouldn't do. I think without rugby, I would have much less of a social life, which is good. I've made pretty much all my friends through rugby. I have got course mates, but you don't spend as much time with them. Rugby, just, yeah, like Toby said earlier, like 3-4 days a week, every week, you're with them, making friends with them, having a laugh, and it's just completely changed. I'd recommend it to anyone coming to uni.
It is who you spend the whole of your time with. I sit next to them, I live with them. It just is a family, really. Yeah, I think it helps massively, like, all wearing the same thing, going down, and then also every year wearing the same thing, because you've seen sometimes with different years we have different stash, or there's people wearing different kit at training, or there's just some aspect of clothing or something that doesn't bring us together, kind of is all separate. But everyone wearing the tweed and having the club tie on and wearing the same kind of thing, whether you're out on a night out or, like I said, down at Colney, whether you're at a Wednesday Bucks game, a Saturday like Norfolk local cup game, or like Derby Day, when you've got hundreds of people down on the hill, but then you've got the 50 or so rugby lads all wearing the same thing, I think it creates a huge atmosphere, and it really makes the club stand out into being one of the clubs that are like a family and are there for each other. So
I think all the highlights of uni experience, all the best experiences are with your rugby mates. You've done things with them that you've probably never done with anyone else in your life, and that's really sets it apart. Huge finish.
Colney's a hard one to explain. You kind of don't know unless you know you play there yourself. To an outsider, it literally just looks like a field with a bank and two rugby sticks in the middle. I mean, that is what it is. But when you're actually playing there and you've got all the boys down on the hill, and especially Derby Day when you've got everyone down on the hill, it means a lot. And I think, like we said earlier, playing rugby with your best mates, that creates strong memories and, you know, memories that I'll cherish for sure.
Playing at Colney is very special. Call it Fortress Colney. You kind of feel like you've got to protect it with your lives. Like you don't want a team to just rock up to your patch and just turn you over. So it gives you that extra fire inside to just go out and play your heart out.
So you know, Colney, you know, has a strong place in my memories for sure. So playing down there, it's nice every time.
Yes! Yes! Oh!
Oh no!
Yeah, fucking yeah. the Ben Germano.
Yeah,
Ben Germano. The Ben Germano.
Yeah. Sure, yeah. Fucking Miles Taylor.
25
to
5, boys.
Top to top.
Boys, I don't know about you. I'm fucking ecstatic. Big shit from everyone. Everyone stepped up today. When it meant it the most, we stepped up and we claimed this fortress back. It's still ours, boys. And this league is for the fucking taking.
Fucking well done.
Favourite memory this season has got to be when Nottingham came down to play us, and the one's got a win and the two's got a win, end of the game, big milkshake, it's one side. That was good fun, that was good to be part of, that was a good feeling, that was good. Milkshake, the milkshake dance, that is UEA's yes, prize dance for victory dance, I would say. I've got no idea about the origins of it or where it comes from, but it's tradition. You got to love a bit of tradition at a rugby club, so it's good. And then when you do the milkshake dance, you know you've won as well, so it's a positive thing, it's a good thing.
Brings all the boys to the yard.
Yeah, it does bring all the boys to the yard. It just came out of nowhere and then that sort of stuck, and that sort of the thing everyone looks forward to.
I don't know, when it first happened, and we was all, there was like, our freshers getting in the middle. I was sat in there and I was thinking, what is going on? I thought everyone was just going to start bundling us or something. And then everyone started seeing bring my milkshake to the yard. And I was like, fair. It's just, everyone looks at it from the outside going, oh, they're so silly and stupid. But it makes the win just, yeah, like you said, the cherry on the top of the cake, makes it just something fun to just finish with.
I think the team's going really well. You know, we had a strong influx of boys come in 2 years ago. They're definitely leaving their mark on the first team. And then the boys that have stepped up big time, I mean, I can't deny it. At the start of the season, I was a little bit wary, having got promoted into the league and having lost some key players. But I think so far we've stepped up big time. A lot of that is due to the team spirit and the mindset that the current squad has towards preparation for rugby. And I think it's definitely showing. I think after the first game against Coventry, and then, you know, when we just kept on churning out results, even when we were playing poorly, kind of made me realise actually we can push on way beyond my initial expectations for the season. And yeah, hopefully I think we can win the league this year. The dynamic of the team has shifted massively, and I think with some people leaving and the influx that we've had in of boys like currently in the second year, you know the whole dynamic and mindset of how we approach rugby has taken a big change, and for the better, I think. I think our physicality has improved. I think the mindset and the togetherness of the team definitely improved, and yeah, it just feels much more of a gel team, and that we're all doing it for each other.
But what I've seen change is the mentality towards the actual of playing. I think when I did join, it was a thing of like a half-assed trying to stitch things up, but now I think people are more committed, and people, we hold each other to a higher standard now, I guess, from what I saw previously. I think now people can't get away with some of the stuff that they were able to, not because of anyone else, but because we hold ourselves to a higher standard.
Let's go!
On your right, Gavin.
Go on, up, go on!
Look,
Get out, Sean!
I just want to say this early, yeah, them kicking the ball out there shows the difference between our intent and their intent win this game, yeah? We fucking want it, we want the points, yeah? They just want to fucking come in at half time, they're happy with the 10-10, yeah? And we fucking shouldn't be.
They're looking in their league, they got Nottingham 2s, we got Nottingham 3s and that. They're thinking they're going to come in and fucking smash us. Look what we've done. They don't fucking want it, they had 15 minutes at the start and then it's all been us.
We've done everything we set at training the last two times and in the change room earlier. We said discipline, we've been disciplined, boys. Boys, they keep the ball and defend. We're defending like we haven't defended all year, boys.
Smart rugby, boys.
We need to play this every, boys. If we play in this half, we will dominate now, boys.
Take the ground and keep pushing through, boys. Let's keep ball in hand and play our fucking game.
Heads up, rugby, and listen.
Boys,
listen,
look at our eyes. Yeah? We're all fucking excited, I can see it.
Yeah.
Look at Mills, look at Rendell, look at Finn, look at Neo, look at all these boys there. We fucking want this game. I'm still hungry, boys. I'm in third gear, boys. I'm in third fucking gear, and I'm ready to go. Let's go, boys. Let's go.
Let's go, boys.
Let's go, boys.
Let's go, boys.
Fucking go, boys.
Yeah, straight at it. Off the off, boys. Let's go. Straight from the start.
Let's go, boys.
Hand off, got to go low, you've got to go low.
Boys, we went down, we didn't let our heads go down. We kept pushing. We are a fucking brotherhood.
It's unfortunate we lost that.
Are you getting in or what?
It's fucking yeah, proud of all of you boys. We kept working till that final whistle. And that's what happens, boys. We work for each other. We're one fucking team, and no matter the result, we're still brothers at the end of the day. Yes. Fucking great game, everyone.
Well, there's loads of reasons why we didn't win. That's just fucking rugby. We'll go away, we'll make some notes, we'll come back and work on those bits. Yeah. And we'll enjoy that. But in the meantime, you can hold your heads up after that performance.
Do you feel better today, even though we lost, because we're actually fucking putting a shift? Like, when we played
that's the best I've seen you boys
We won, but we're still on to be un-fucking defeated in the league, boys. That'd be huge.
Let's keep that now.
Use that fire. Use the parts of that game. We were fucking running rings around them, boys. We were up there physically and running rings around them. Take that and move it into the rest of the season.
The first team have played. They've played well this season. Very well this season. We got off to an absolute flyer at Coventry. They were coming down from 1A. Down to 2A, and going away from home first game, we thought, right, this could be the toughest game of the season. The boys just turned up, they were just there, and we ran riot. We ran absolute riot. They couldn't handle us. And then in the league, we've stayed unbeaten, so I think we've won five games on the bounce. Little slip up, we're not playing as well as we did at the start, but I think we know we can do it. It's just keeping on training. Keeping on fitness and then getting back to that top level rugby that we know we can produce.
So there was a lot more balls than two in there.
You just have to play.
They party some of our
balls. We had the World Cup ones in our house.
Yeah, they're not.
The World Cup ones are ours.
Let's get them out.
Right, let's get going. What are you on about?
I was on about. Two attackers stand here, they pass it to one attacker, there's two defenders, the guy runs in, the two try and hold him up, and the next guy comes and drives
we'll
through.
We'll step back to the boat. Let's do this for like 2 minutes and then change it. Go down! Yo, on left, Rick.
One. Two, skip! Two, two, right! Hard!
Good parry!
Hard!
Boys, flash. Switch. Rewind.
Turn over! Hold form.
We need to turn up fucking aggressive because it's going to be like this. It's going to be wet, it's going to be horrible, and Warwick won't know what's hit him. That there was the best session we've had all year, hands down. It was fantastic. The run through was good, the aggression was there, the intensity was there. It was fantastic. We know when we went wrong against Warwick, we know we are better than them. We're just going to turn up, hit them hard, get up, out the line, hit them hard, hit them low, drive them straight back. They won't know what's hitting.
Oh, lads. Switch on.
Oh, my God. Oh, wait. Drop my legs.
Yeah, give me that. Let's go, boys.
Let's bring it in tight.
Let's go, you.
Jog in, lads.
Fucking huge intensity from that kickoff or receiving. I want fucking aggression. I've seen that you boys are fucking good. I saw it on Monday night against us at the end, alright? Okay? Let's fucking get intense. Let's get aggressive, alright? And let's run them off the fucking park.
We've been talking about it for weeks. Since we lost that game, today has been our race. We've been building up, we've done well. We did well against Lincoln. We did well in training on Monday. But now it's up to you.
We've got something in this team that's really special. Yeah, you've got a closeness and a spirit to work for each other that's fucking exceptional. Runs right through all teams. Thirds never used to have it. They've got it now, that's for sure.
Let's fucking do this, yeah, for three. Let's go, boys.
One, two, three,
Thank you.
UEA has been really welcoming, to be honest. Like, I've only been here for like, what, 5-6 months, and I've already made like loads of friends. And you know, all the myths that your parents tell you, like, you're gonna make friends for a lifetime, I already know that, even knowing these guys like for 5 months. Like, especially at rugby, the second and third years, they've welcomed us like as if we've known them forever, to be honest. And yeah, lectures have been going well. Everything has been going well, to be honest, yeah. Next year I'm going to live with 5 other rugby mates, and I've only known them for 5 months, so yeah. So we're most probably going to get a house all together, going to live in it for 2 years, and going to make some good memories.
I think rugby creates such strong friendships due to certainly an element of the physicality and the contact of the sport. You know, within training, when you're kind of knocking lumps out of each other, it's all, you know, in good heart, and everyone takes it well. But also the fact that, especially at UEA and at uni, I found it's probably the closest that I've felt to my other team members within the sports team, purely because you're just doing everything together. You know, we study together, we eat together, we go out together, training, gym, all the rest of it. Your whole schedule is, you know, built around the other boys. So yeah, I think you just build very close relationships with people, and those carry on way past uni. But rugby, you know, you're with like-minded people, and that definitely helps throughout university.
I can't believe that like the 4 years has come and gone now. Like, yeah, I can't quite describe like my feelings towards UEA rugby. Like, I love the club, I love the boys in it, I love the atmosphere about it, I love everything about UEA rugby. Like, going from being like a fresher to captain to prez, like, I've kind of seen each of the different levels of the club, and like, it's just an unbelievable organisation, an unbelievable group of boys. Yeah, and I think that's a massively special thing about this club. You'll never get anything else like this anywhere.
What I have seen, however, in my 6 years of being here is us slip over a few times because we've got a little bit complacent. We've got a little bit too confident in respect that certain individuals within a group will feel that the job's done almost, and that we're unbeatable, and on our day we are unbeatable. What's really, really important is that we see this season out. And there's 2 games left of the league, is we see this out with our absolute utmost professionalism, focus and determination, yeah, to put everybody else in this league, the last 2 teams, in their place and nail it. And I mean absolutely nail it. Because next year, you playing your very best will be tight games, and sometimes we'll lose. Well, they are the times of your life, the best times of your life, the days where you go away and you will take these all the way through to being an old man. You'll tell your children and your grandchildren about it, the experiences you had, and go to their university games. So let's finish this season out, yeah? Let's finish this season out and do ourselves the honour of patting each other on the back at the end of the season, saying, we absolutely nailed that. We are the best team in the league. We are the best team in this group, and we're now in the top flight of rugby next season.
Everybody put it fucking on the line now, yeah? Second last box game, we're ready for this, yeah? Win the league here, and it's gonna be a fucking sick year for UEA.
I will crawl off this pitch for you boys today. Yeah. All I'm asking is that you boys do the exact same.
Start the sweep! Derby day. Derby day, I would argue, is the pinnacle day. Again, against big rivals Essex. Again, I mentioned tradition. It's a tradition, UEA versus Essex. It gets very, very hyped up, very big. We put a lot of work into it. It's very exciting. The boys work hard for it. It's a good day of rugby that involves the whole university.
I think the hype going into it, because there's a big break from Bucks games before Derby Day, so you're building up in training for ages and you know that it's the biggest game of the season.
It's just a buzz. It's just everything about it. And it's hard to say when you're as a fresher. You just don't know it until you experience it. Like, there's a certain feeling about the day and you get butterflies before the game, and that is huge. And it just, you can tell that it means so much to everyone.
Coney Lane will certainly make a difference to Derby Day, the Derby Day thing. I think Essex have got travel. We've got travel quite early from what I've heard as well. They're coming to Coney Lane's changing rooms, which probably aren't what they're used to. A bit small, a bit cramped, a bit hostile for the away team. We're used to it week in, week out. We know what Coney Lane's about. They won't like it. Essex won't like it.
I think it'll make us fight harder. Yeah. And I think with the loss from last year, we're going to be firing all cylinders when we come out. Yes. And I think actually it's going to be a really good day and I'm looking forward to it.
It was a close-fought game, very close-fought game. It could have gone either way in the dying minutes. But I think a bit of ill discipline, a few missed tackles led to them scoring in the last minute and then consequently winning. But I think moving on to this year at home, the boys are going to be up for it.
So losing Derby Day last year was really shit, obviously. Put a lot of effort into it, and it was such a hard loss for the boys, because it literally came down to the final tee, them scoring on the left side on the try line with literally the game over. It's going to mean a lot more for the boys to kind of go out there with a bit of vengeance in them to kind of redeem themselves and take back the title, which we deserve.
Without further ado, here's the squad. Oliver Mills, Finn Martin, Louis Frost, Adam Smith, Jack Guest, Chao Chanda, Will Perry, Benjamin Rendell, James Brading, Cam Baker, Fumi, Ben Schultz, Sandy, Dan Shep, Abraham, Maskell, Guruhu, Sinclair, Kingdon, James Murphy, Seb Carter, and Nir Maponya.
It's the night before Derby Day. I don't know what really is going through my head at the moment. I'm most nervous now than I have been before any other match. It's one thing that goes through my mind every game is, and not many other people experience it, but it's weird knowing that you're going to every match being the smallest on the pitch, and it's sort of always like you have to prove to everyone why you're there, even if it's you lack the physique. But I think it just goes to show it's all about mentality. I love leading from the front. I love the fitness. I think it just shows that technique and timing beats sort of power and physicality. One of the things I'm most looking forward to is playing with the team of boys that is on the 15, so it's one of the greatest feelings a rugby player can have when they look at every team member and think they'll give 110%, knowing that on the day they'll bring the job. This is what you play rugby for. This is why you pay your membership. This is why we wake up early. This is why we go into training. this is why we beat each other up for 80 minutes, just because you know that everyone around you is going to do exactly the same thing. And the brothers that I've made during my 3 times here are very special, and I've had some incredible memories with them. And it's an experience that I'll remember for the rest of my life. So I want to say thank you, boys. So stoked to get on the pitch with you tomorrow. I don't think I'm going to sleep well tonight. I'll be up and down, toilet. I can't wait to play with you lads. I'm going to give it my all, and hopefully we get the W. And I have every confidence in you guys to absolutely smash it. And let's do this, boys. Let's get that win.
Boys, it's that fucking keyword, that buzzword I've been saying all season. Fucking relentless. From the get-go, impose your fucking will to win and how much this game means to you on the fucking opposition. You hear that gear first 10 minutes and you fucking maintain it for the whole game. Relentless going forward, ruthless and fucking intense in defence, boys. Show how much this game fucking means to you, yeah? Run through the fuckers, smack him back 5 yards, yeah? Let's fucking have it from the offset and maintain it for the 80, boys. That's fucking what Derby Day is about.
Putting your quality on your line for your brothers. Maintain our discipline at all times. Pedal and count low. Very low, boys. Low chat, everything through chat, okay?
You know at times tonight you're gonna be fucked. And if you're not fucking up right now, like, is that you fucking push through that? That is gonna be the deciding factor if we win or not. Is that what you fucking wanna work? It's like the 80 fuck. Everyone in this room can fucking work for 80 minutes.
This is what we work for, boys!
This is what we work
up until this moment. I want all of you to look me in the eye and let them know that you're ready for this, boys. You know the job you're gonna do today, because we are fucking here, and we're UEA boys, we're ready to play our fucking arrows!
Come on!
Our third, boys! The most successful team in this country for fucking reason! This weekend, week out, every single one of you goes out there, leaves your bodies on the line!
the only reason they're getting through at the end there is because we're having a lapse in our judgment, yeah. Because we're like, oh, well, can I get there, can I not? Because we're all getting a bit tired. Just fucking dig deep.
He's playing heads up in defence, yeah? Because their forward runners are pretty lazy, but when they run onto it, they're fucking running hard, yeah? But like they're getting away and they're using those lazy runners because they're just staying on the blind side every time, and that's how they've got that try, boys.
Start calling those hards, those softs. Make sure everyone in that line knows what's happening. So that's where the confusion's coming from, boys. Some people running hard, some people drifting. Make sure we all do it as a team. Make that call, relay it down the line and move as a team.
Last thing, you got 40 minutes. Remember that 40 minutes when we were a man down, yeah? Remember that 40 minutes when we were a man down. Remember that 40 minutes when we were down against fucking Nottingham, boys. This is where it counts. Get back in their faces, play the game where they fucking belong in their 22, and let's take it to them, boys. You got 15 minutes left, 15 to correct it. Let's fucking go.
I'm only 23. la 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 la.
Some pre-match skills for maybe like a edits video at the end or some bloopers or something. Mum and Dad, you taught me very well, but the only thing I think you fail is no balls in the house. I can't get enough.